Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston and the International Space Station update. We're here with the International Space Station Flight Control Team inside the Space Station Flight Control Room at the Mission Control Center in Houston. On board the International Space Station, the six Expedition 32 crew members are halfway through their day. Commander Gennady Padanka, U.S. Flight Engineers Joe Akava and Sonny Williams, Japanese Flight Engineer Aki Hoshide, and Russian flight engineers Yuri Malenchenko and Sergey Revin got their wake-up call at 1 a.m. Central Time this morning and have been steadily making their way through their scheduled activities. The crew has been together for almost a full month now since William, Hoshide, and Malenchenko arrived aboard their Soyuz 31S on July 16th. They've been in space for 32 days and at the space station for 30, and they're planning to stay until November. Akava, Padanka, and Revin, on the other hand, launched on May 14th and have been in space now for 93 days at the station for 91. They'll be heading back to the Earth in their own Soyuz vehicle next month. With two spacewalks coming up before the end of the month, one in less than a week, activities today are again focused on preparation, particularly for the Russian spacewalk, which is scheduled for Monday. Commander Gennady Padanka and Flight Engineer Yuri Malenchenko have been working with their Orlan Russian spacesuits, installing NASA helmet lights and cameras on those suits with help from Sonny Williams, and also configuring their communication systems and checking out the telemetry and biomedical sensors. They're scheduled to perform that spacewalk beginning at 9:40 a.m. on Monday, and NASA TV coverage of the 6.5-hour-long excursion will begin at 9 a.m. Central Time. Elsewhere on the station, the other Expedition 32 crew members have been busy with science experiments. Flight Engineer Joe Akava spent some time today working on ACE, or the Advanced Colloid Experiment, which looks at the flow characteristics and evolution and ordering effects of colloids in microgravity. Meanwhile, Sonny Williams and Aki Hoshide were both scheduled to spend some time with the Integrated Cardiovascular Experiment, which studies the decrease of the heart muscle that the astronauts experience while in space. Hoshide also took part in the Pro-K experiment, which looks at how diet can decrease bone loss while in microgravity. And this afternoon we'll begin a session of the circadian rhythms experiment. That experiment examines how long stays in space, where the sun rises and sets 16 times a day, affect the body's circadian rhythms, which are their 24-hour light-dark cycle. The team here on the ground will command the visiting autonomous transfer vehicle's thrusters to fire for 31 minutes and 16 seconds and raise the space station to an altitude of 254 miles. It's part of a regular schedule of reboost for the space station, but will also help the station take advantage of the propellant brought up by the European ATV. Also, begin getting them into place for the next Soyuz departure from the space station next month.